report.
We prescribe, we admit them, these workers are there, but they buy gun medicines.
How can the lab work well without gloves?
Now, do we have the pharmacy nearby where they buy from?
There are some drug shops.
Drug shops, okay.
And some pharmacies are coming.
Dr. Mujuni Ivan is the medical superintendent at Rukunyu Hospital in Kamwenge District. The queues to access the pharmacy are ever long here. Many times, patients don't get the prescribed medication. There is an acute shortage of drugs and the limited human resource worsen the distress in this facility. As Dr. Mujuni explains, even the space to handle patients is not sufficient.
And we would have received the third delivery now in this financial year. But we are still waiting for the second delivery. The first delivery came late in September. And the population we have here is now big because we have a lot of refugees. We have a lot of people who have malaria season. So we are having actually drug shortages. And this one we expect to go on up to like mid of December when the National Medical Stores will bring the next.
The members of parliament are appealing to government to pay special attention to this facility.
We are interested in equipment, see what you have at this level of the hospital. We have already toured around. We discover you don't have an x-ray. And of course, you know at the hospital, we are supposed to be having an x-ray. We have looked at your scan.
Self promotion and health education. So we'd like to hear from the DSO if he has some time to talk to us about what he's doing in order to modernize market to have that aspect of great promotion, not only looking at coming to health facilities.
Legislators want the Ministry of Health to ensure Rukunyu is properly funded, especially because of the hundreds of patients they serve every day, including refugees.
I cannot blame National Medical Stores because the work of National Medical Stores is very clear: to procure, to store and distribute medicines. So they cannot distribute more than what they don't have. So that now comes to our objective of coming here as a parliamentary health committee. We are realizing that the population of Uganda has gone on growing and growing and growing, and the health budget has not been done what? Has not been improved. So you cannot blame, there is no any party to blame here. It's about looking at the budget of health and everything will be okay.
Thing is that facilities over time have been upgraded. From health center 2, a facility can be upgraded to health center 3. From 3, it is upgraded to health center 4. And then from 4, it upgraded to hospital. But I think there has not been enough consideration by each level. Because if you have to move from health center 2 to health center 3, the Ministry of Health.
The committee.